Hey guys, I hope quarantine has been treating you well, and I just wanted to do like more low-key video. So I figured I'd talk about my first Fire Emblem, because I haven't talked about like how I got into Fire Emblem, how all that happened, so I figured might as well make a video for it. So our story begins with my family. We're going away on a trip. And typically when we go away on a trip, we get to like pick out games that we bring with us on the trip to like, you know, keep us entertained so we don't get bored. And so we go to Target and my mom says, pick out a game, I'll pay for it, don't worry about it. And I'm like, okay, cool. And so at the time I was addicted to anything anime. I was like, oh my god, I love anime. This is my personality trait, right? Like, I was that child. And then so I'm looking at all of the covers and I see one and I'm like, oh, that's cool. It has two people on it with... It has two people on it. With swords, and I was like, oh, that looks awesome, it looks cool, and it's Fire Emblem Awakening. And I hadn't heard of Fire Emblem, I had known nobody that had played Fire Emblem, so I was like, you know what, I'll just pick up the game. Can't hurt. I did no research on it, I was just there, I was like, you know what, it's Fire Emblem time, baby. And so as soon as I booted up my DS and it had me creating an avatar, and I was like, oh, this is really cool. Like, I get to make myself. And I remember giving myself like really obnoxious blue hair because that's what I really wanted at the time. Like, my emo dreams, that is what I craved. And then I met Crom, and let me tell you, Crom, when you first play Fire Emblem Awakening as a girl, you just have this wonderful, wonderful need to marry Crom, and that's actually really convenient because you probably will end up marrying Crom as he attempts to marry the person nearest to him after defeating Gangrel. So I married Crom. I was infatuated with this man. I loved him so much. Like, I actually didn't know that I could choose to marry someone else. I thought no matter what, I had to marry Crom. I thought, oh, I wonder how the game plays if I'm a guy, because I can't marry Crom. Well, first of all, Crom loves you no matter what, I feel like, but obviously you can't marry Crom when you play as a guy, so I didn't really know that was a thing. I didn't know there was other options. And I remember, slight spoilers for Fire Emblem Awakening, if you want to skip it, just click here. I remember crying so much when Emrin died. I don't know why I was so emotional over this, but when Emrin died, like, I was in the feels. I was like, damn. Crom's sister, what are we gonna do? She died. Like, it was totally out of left field for me. I did not see it coming whatsoever, and I was so shocked, and I was like, oh my god, like, oh my god, she died. Like, so I was wrong then. I don't know why it had me so emotional. Like, I literally feel no emotions when I see it now, but back then, like, that gave me so much feels. Speaking of feels, what about the soundtrack for this game? It's amazing. So I'm actually replaying Fire Emblem Awakening right now, my own time. And this soundtrack is sexy, straight up. It is so good, just like... And maybe it's because I have nostalgic ties to it, but oh my god, it is so good. Like, just the 3DS eras of Fire Emblem music were so good. So good. Everything is a constant bop. I don't think there's a single track in the game that I hate. Like, I just adore it. I don't know if I'd like it more than Fire Emblem Fates music. Fire Emblem Fates music is like top tier for me. I could never listen to a soundtrack more. I'm addicted to it. And so I love the Fire Emblem Awakening soundtrack. I have memories of immediately promoting my units when they hit level 10. Like, I would just grind Lissa out until she hit level 10 and I'd just promote her right then and there. And speaking of promoting, I'd think, so when I did end up finding out about, like, the fact I could marry characters, I just married Muriel and Virion because they just had the S support, like, right ready, and I was like, alright, so I'll just marry them. So I married them, and I remember making Muriel like a dark knight or whatever it was, and I don't know if that's necessarily the best idea, but I have memories of them being like my dream team, like them caring. I'm always like, oh, there's a problem, send in the tag team of Muriel and Virion in. And for no reason whatsoever, I hated Sumia because she was constantly after my man. Like, Sumia would be like, oh, Krom, and I'd be like, why? Why are you like this? That is my husband. That is my man. How dare you? Same for Cordelia. They're both in the same boat for me. I have no reason why. I just have an irrational dislike towards them. Like, they're great characters. Like, I love them. But for some reason, just a little bit of me is just like, I don't like you whatsoever. I don't. We wouldn't be friends in real life. Do not talk to me. Which I just, this is so funny. And I was really confused when other kids, except for like Lucina and Morgan, showed up. Like, so my first child that I got was Kajel. And I apologize if I say that wrong, but I got Kajel and I was like, who is this chick? Just a random recruit on a paralog? Okay, cool. Like, I had totally missed the memo that it was Sully's daughter and Sully and Stahl. Yeah, that it was her daughter. But, like, so I just didn't like Kajel. And then I found out, like, it was her daughter, and so I felt obligated to use Kajel, and I ended up just being so resentful towards my game for that. I'm like, I feel like I have to use her, but I don't want to. And then this also came back to haunt me. I bought Cypher cards for the first time like a few years ago, and the first Cypher card I see when I open it up is this Kajel card, and I was like, damn. It's really coming back to haunt me. And I'm also kind of salty about the cards I got in there. Although the Cordelia card I got was actually quite pretty. Same with the Azura one, even though I hate Azura, but that's something for another day. Anyways, no one else knew about Fire Emblem. I finished Fire Emblem Fates in like 4 days. Like, I seriously grinded through it. I was addicted. The gameplay was amazing for me. And I was like, yeah, I love this. And one day, like, I'm sitting at my lunch table or whatever, and my friend is like, oh, what? Like, I'm like, oh, what are you playing? And he's like, oh, you wouldn't know it. And I was like, bitch, shut up. Don't even be like that. And I looked at it. My homie playing Fire Emblem Fates. And I'm like, what is that? That looks like Fire Emblem. He's like, it is Fire Emblem. I'm like, they made another one? They made a sequel to Awakening? And he was like, no, this is Fire Emblem Fates. And I'm like, oh, they made another Fire Emblem game. I didn't know that. Is it out? And he's like, yeah, duh. I have it right here. I'm like, okay, so I'm gonna go buy that. And then what's more, showed up to Target a few years later, of course, and I picked up my very first copy of Fire Emblem Conquest, and I remember playing Conquest thinking, oh my god, this plot is so cool. This is so awesome. And then now when I look back at it, I literally cannot read any of the lines in the plot without gagging furiously. It is, oof. It do be kind of bad though. So yeah, that was the story of my first Fire Emblem. Oh, another tidbit to add. I love Morgan. He's my little baby boy. I actually have him plus 10 just for like nostalgia's sake, because I don't know why, but when this child came into my life, when I was playing Fire Emblem Awakening, oh my god, like, I was changed. For some reason, I also didn't like Lucina because of that weird point where she tries to kill you in the game, which is, like, really weird, but I kind of held a grudge on her, like, for the rest of time just because of that. Don't know why, but I'm just really pissed me off, and I think she's mad annoying. But Morgan was my little son, and as soon as I got Morgan, I just replaced Lucina with Morgan because I just love him and I would die for him and I would just risk it all for Morgan. So yeah, about plus 10 in Heroes, my Morgan, and I care for him. I love him so very much. Anyways, I think that's all I have to say. Let me know if you enjoyed this video. I might do more story times like this, or maybe character rants where I just talked about characters I enjoy. Anyways, my name has been Optel. Thank you all so much for watching, and bye-bye.